Hi again, Azure learners. Welcome to Tech Tips video. My name is Hanna Engel, a Microsoft Technical Trainer, and today it is my pleasure to tell you all about network security groups. So in this video, we're going to discuss, okay, what the network security groups really are. Why do we need them? What's the difference between an NSG network security group and a firewall? We have firewall. Do we need NSGs as well? Good question. We'll explain where we can assign NSGs, to what can we assign NSGs. We will look through the default rules, and I will show you how to add a new rule to override the default ones. So first of all, let me get started with a little story, with a little comparison. Before I go into technical details, I want you to have a general idea of what NSGs are and what better way to understand how a tool works than to compare it to everyday life. So let's imagine we are moving into a new flat. We are moving into a new flat. It's a total chaos. We have lots of stuff. We had lots of cardboard boxes. We have buckets. We have everything that we had in our previous flat. And now we need to sort it. Now we need to decide whether our things fit into our apartment, or maybe they will be left in a garage, or maybe I don't need it anymore and I will throw it out. But that's a lot of work. So we invite a friend, the friend comes over, and they open the first box and they take out the spoon and they ask, hey, where do I put this? And you tell them, to the kitchen. Okay. They open another box, they take out a book, they ask, hey, where do I put this? And so on and so forth. Now, that's not much of a help, right? They keep bothering you with questions. So you tell them, you know what? All of the stuff from the red cardboard box, it goes to the kitchen. All the stuff from the gray one, it goes to the bedroom, unless it's a book, then it stays in the living room. And you see this green box over there? I don't need this stuff anymore. That's not going to enter my apartment. So what you have just done, you configured traffic rules in your apartment. And that's a little bit how NSGs work. They can allow or deny traffic entering within your virtual networks, entering your VMs. So NSGs let you filter your traffic within your virtual networks. And why is it so important to keep in mind that they let you do it inside of your networks? Well, because now we go to another topic. So what's the difference between firewall and NSG? Why do I need NSG? I already have my firewall, right? Well, the main difference between firewall and NSG is the fact that firewall sits on the perimeter of your network. So firewall is this bodyguard that decides, okay, you enter, you leave, you have many different rules in firewall, you have monitoring capabilities. Firewall is just so much more powerful than NSG. But then why do we need NSGs, right? Since we have a firewall. Well, NSGs sit inside of your networks. So they manage, they allow or deny certain traffic that already entered your networks, but now you need to distribute it between subnets, between particular VMs. And I hope you already know from the zero trust methodology that on each layer, we need to apply the least privileged rule, least privileged access. So those NSGs, they let you manage your traffic between subnets. And hey, a good news is that NSGs are free. You can create as many NSGs as you wish and as many as you want to manage, right? Okay, so now that we know that, okay, NSG is nothing else but a list of rules that helps you filter your traffic, the incoming and traffic that leaves your subnets, your VMs. But now, where can I deploy it? On what level can I assign them? So let's take a look at the whiteboard. An NSG is nothing else but the list of rules, like, right? That's what we said. So we have our NSG, let's say created with the default rules only. And now, to what can we assign our NSG? Do you know? We have two options. The first one, we can assign an NSG on the level of a subnet. And that's the recommended option. Or we can choose to assign an NSG on a NIC level of a specific virtual machine, NIC, network interface card. So it's important to remember that we do not assign NSG on the level of the VNet. This is not the case. We assign NSG on the level of a subnet or on the level of a NIC. Now, recommended assignment is on the subnet level, because if you have a couple of virtual machines inside of a subnet, then you have this administrative overhead to keep, you need to keep thinking that, I need to remember to update my rules, not only on the NSG on a subnet level, but also on the NIC level. That can get complicated very easily. But if that's something that you need, then by all means, you can do it. And you can assign the same NSG to different subnets. The only requirement is that the NSG and the subnet you're assigning into are in the same region. Okay, so let's go to Azure. And let's have a look at how those NSGs, those network security groups, look like in real life. So I'm in my Azure portal. I can make it a tad bigger. And I go to network security groups. And you can see this is the list of all of my network security groups. I will choose the one I prepare beforehand. And the very first thing you see are the inbound and outbound security rules. NSG allows you to manage your inbound and outbound traffic. An important note though, a VM inside of a subnet can establish an outbound connection and then receive the response by default. We don't have to configure a rule letting in the response for the communication that was established, that was initiated by a VM. The connection is stateful. I hope it makes sense. Okay, so we have those two kinds of rules, inbound and outbound. Second thing that we can notice is that I did not lie to you that indeed we can assign this NSG on a network interface level, but here in this, for this NSG, it is not associated with any, or on a level of a subnet. And, surprise, it is not associated with any subnet either, but I can change it. I can click associate, I choose the virtual network, and I choose the subnet I want to associate it with. And that's it. Okay, now let's look closer at the rules that we have. It's important to note that I did not configure this NSG anyhow. I just created a resource and I left it as it is. But you can already see some rules here, right? So where are they coming from? I did not add them. Someone else did? I don't think so. Well, those are the default rules. How do I know that they are default? Well, I have two options to recognize that. The first one, I look at the priority number, and the default rules start at 65,000 priority number. Another hint I have that these are the default rules is the fact that I cannot delete them. You see, I'm trying to click on the bin, but it's grayed out. I cannot delete them. Okay, but you might say, but what if I don't like those rules? What if I have a requirement in my environment, in my network, and I don't need a rule that denies all inbound. That's not something I want. Well, in order to override the default rules, you need to create another rule with a lower number, so with a higher priority. You can create rules with a priority as small as 100. You cannot create a rule with priority number one. The lowest you can go is 100. And 100 is going to be the most important rule in your NSG. And then after 100, other rules will be analyzed if the first rule doesn't match the traffic. Okay, so now that we are at the priority, let's talk a little bit more about what those default rules enforce in our environment. So let's imagine I'm a traffic. And right now I will talk only about inbound rules. So about receiving traffic, the incoming traffic. So I am a traffic coming from the internet and I want to enter into the VM. So I go through the firewall, I enter the VNet. I first need to enter a subnet where this VM is located. So depending whether there is an NSG associated, I will have to process the rules there. So remember, I associated this NSG with my subnet. So okay, I'm a traffic. Unfortunately, I need to process some rules. So I look at the table and I start with the rule that has the smallest number, so the highest priority. Okay, I don't care about the name. It doesn't tell me much. I look at the port and protocol, which are any. Okay, this rule refers to me. I go further and I see source and destination. This rule refers to the traffic coming from the virtual network to the same virtual network or the peered network. So this rule refers to the traffic moving around in the same network or the peered network. But I said I'm coming from the internet, so I'm not coming from the virtual network. So this rule doesn't apply to me. I'm not even looking at the action. I just move to another rule. Okay, I look at another rule. I don't care about the name. Port and protocol any. Okay, that's me. Source Azure Load Balancer. Well, I said I'm directly from the internet. So I'm unlucky. This rule doesn't apply to me either. So I go to the last rule. I don't care about the name. I look at the port protocol any. Okay. And source destination, any. Okay, that's me. So what can I do? Well, unfortunately, I cannot enter. The action is deny. So I hope you understand how the rules work. That when the traffic enters and it finds the first rule that matches all the criteria, it only looks at the action. We have two options, allow or deny. And then it stops processing all the other rules that are below this rule. I hope it makes sense. Okay, so now I want to create a new rule. Let's say I want to allow RDP traffic. So I go to inbound security rules. I click add. Source, let's leave it on any. Destination. And here we have something interesting. Let's look at the application security group. What is application security group? It sounds very serious, right? Security application. Ooh. Well, application security group is nothing more but a tool that helps you manage your NSGs. You create an application security group, you associate with it some virtual machines, and now you don't have to create a separate rule for every virtual machine. You just put them into one application security group and you decide, okay, my destination is application security group. You choose the security group you created. I pre-created one for you. And that's it. And now the rule understands to what VMs this rule applies to. Of course, you can choose a service, but let's just keep it up. Here it is. Let's change it to RDP. So automatically the port changes into RDP. And you choose action, allow or deny. So I want to allow RDP traffic. And now I decide on priority. if I create a role with a priority 100, then no other role will ever override this role I created. So maybe 100 is not the best option because it's just the first role that I create in my environment. So maybe let's make it 300. I give it a name. Allow any RDP inbound sounds okay to me, but of course I can change it. And I click add. And here we have a warning that, hey, maybe exposing RDP, allowing our direct RDP traffic is not the best idea, is not a recommended practice, but that's just for the example, for you to see how to create a role. So I hope it makes sense to you. I hope that now you feel more confident, you feel more familiar, you feel that NSGs are more familiar to you and less scary, less incomprehensible. Let me know if you have any questions. Reach out to me on LinkedIn, Hanna Engel. If you have any questions, any feedback, I'm more than happy to help you. So thank you very much for watching this video and see you on another Tech Tips.